I'm going to start with the decorators. Suppose, what exactly the decorators is, what is the use of this decorators. Before that, I'm just going to give you some example. Suppose this is the function we are having. I'm going to define a function def, and suppose div is the function I'm going to define, and I'm going to pass the parameter n command. And it's fine, I'm just going to print n divided by n. I'm going to call this function div 4, 2. Yeah, it's perfectly fine, we are getting 2.0. But suppose if I'm going to pass 2, 4, then what will happen? The 2 divided by 4, and you will get the result 0.5. But I don't want to do this. What I'm looking for, if the second value is greater than the first value, I want to swap the value. If the first one is 4, the second one is 2, it's perfectly fine. But if the second value is greater than the first value, then I want to swap the value internally. Okay, we don't have any problem, I can do that. I'm just going to write if m greater than n, then I'm going to swap the value. How we can swap the value? We can simply write n comma m is equal to m comma n. This is how you can apply the swap in the Python single line code. Now I'm going to write print n comma m divided by n. Now we are getting the result properly, like 2.0 is there. If I'm going to go 4, 2, again we are getting 2.0. If I'm going to give 2, 4, again we are getting perfectly fine, we are 2.0. So this is how we can arrange this function. But right now this function is there with you, the code is there with you, everything, you are independent, like you are free to write anything in this function. So now you can do anything with this particular function, that's not a problem. But the problem will come when this function is not there with you. Suppose this function is defined in some model, this function is defined in some other module. This function is, suppose this this function is available with some server and all. The source code we don't have for the function. We don't have the source code of this function. So my objective is, I want to redefine the function. I want to add some additional functionality with the function. But the problem is, we don't have the source code. Right now we are having the source code, so we can do anything. Right now we are having the source code, so we can do anything. But suppose this function is available with some module. In that case, how we can define that function? Because that particular function is not the part of yours. So the question is, if we don't have the function in our source code, suppose the function is written in some other places, the function is located in some other places, like it's available with some module, like it's available with some server and all. So what I want to do, I want to define the function, I want to apply some additional functionality with the function, with the existing function. For that purpose, what we can use? We can use decorators. So what exactly the decorators is? Using decorator, we can add, extra features. We can add extra feature with existing function. At compile time. Remember, function is defined in some other place. Like it's in some different modules and all. In that case, how we can do this? for that purpose we can use decorators. So decorator is what, by the use of decorator we can add extra features with existing function at compile time. Remember, the function is defined in some other place. The source code is not there with me. The source code is not there with me. For this purpose, what we can use? We can use the decorators. Now, I am going to just remove this all. This is my function, suppose. And the challenge is, I need to add some functionality with this function. But the question is, I don't need to touch the function. Without touching this function, I want to change the functionality of this function. This is the challenge. The challenge is how we can write something in this function without touching this function. The answer is decorators. So what we can do, I'm just going to define a method over there. I'm just going to write def, and I'm just going to give like sdiv, a smart div. I'm going to define it another function over there, and I'm just going to pass like parameter. It can be anything. I'm just going to pass like this. Remember, here we are passing the function as a parameter. Remember, div is a function. So I am just going to pass this div over there when I will call this. So I am passing this function over there. Remember, in Python you can pass, we can pass function as a parameter. This is the beauty of this Python. We can pass function as a parameter. Here we are passing the function as a parameter. Okay. Remember, in Python, the beauty of Python is we can define a function within a function, a function within a function. In other programming languages, we don't have this feature. In other programming languages, we don't have this feature, but here we can do that. And for the decorator, we need to do this. Okay, I am going to define a function, and this function I am going to pass these parameters over there. Now, what I need to do? I am going to create the inner function over there. Suppose I am going to give the name def inner. In this inner function, I am going to pass the parameter. Remember, this will be the same parameter like this. So I am just going to pass the parameter n, n. So I am just going to pass the parameter. Here I am writing if n less than m. You need to write the all the code over there that was written earlier over there. I am writing n comma m is equal to m comma n. So I am just going to swap the value, and I am just going to return, this function. I am just going to return this function to n comma m. And finally, the entire function is going to return the inner function. So I am just going to return inner. Now, what I need to do, I'm just going to write div1 is equal to sdiv. I'm going to call in the sdiv. This is the function I'm going to call. In this function, I'm going to pass the parameter. So I'm just going to pass the parameter div over there. Div. Now, if I'm going to write div1 and I'm going to pass the parameter 2, 4, see the result. We are getting 2.0. If I'm going to pass 4, 2, we are getting the result 2.0. So this is what? This is the decorator function. Why it's called decorator? Because here we are calling the another function. Yeah, we are calling this function over there. In this particular function, we are manipulating the things, like we need to use the inner function over there. It can be, the name can be anything, the parameter will be the same. And here we are writing the code and all, and here we are returning the function. Like this inner function will return this function, and here we are passing the return inner. This function will return the inner. The inner function will return that particular function. Now what I need to do, I am calling the object of this function sdiv. I am passing the parameter. like div function over there. So it will return the value to the div1. Now I am passing div1 4, 2, and we are getting this result. So this is what, this is called decorator. We can also write like this. It's not necessary to use just like this. We can also like, I just write this thing for your clarity. We can also write like this, div is equal to sdiv. I am going to create a new div, and that particular new div will be the sdiv, and I am going to pass the div. So this particular div is, I am talking about this div, and this is the new div over there, and I am just going to call the div 2, 4, 2. So when we are talking about div 2, 4, I am talking about this particular div. So either we can create the different function over there, or we can create the same function over there. It's your choice. So this is what the challenge get accepted over there. Without touching this particular code, I make the, all the changes over there, and everything is perfectly fine, just like the earlier. So this is what, this is the decorator. This is the beauty of the Python. Number one, we can define a function within a function. Yeah, in the decorator we are doing this. Number two, within a function you can pass parameter, function as a parameter. Yes, we are passing the function as a parameter. Number three, we can assign a function to a function. See, we are assigning this function to a function. We are assigning this function to a function. So this is exactly the beauty of this Python. So in the decorator, we are not going to touch this function, but still we are able to make the modifications with this particular code. So this is what exactly that decorator is. So in the decorator, what you need to do, I'm just going to create a function. The compulsory thing is you need to pass the parameter function as a parameter. The second thing, we are going to define the inner function. In the inner function, it can be, name can be anything, but the parameter will be the same. I need to do all the stuff over there. Whatever the code I write earlier with this particular function, all the code I am writing over here. And finally, I am returning this function. Yeah, let's get completed now. Now what I need to do, because this function is going to return the inner function, so I am just going to call the return inner. Now I am calling this function. The interesting thing is, I am just going to assign a function with function. I am writing div is equal to sdiv of div. Now I am writing div of 2, 4, we are getting the result. This name can be different, or it can be the same. So this is what exactly the decorator is. It's clear what exactly the decorator is. It's not only the decorator, it's also your question, like how to define a function within a function. This is how we can do that. What is the use of the function within a function? For the decorator, it's compulsory to define a function within a function, so that I can make the modifications.